Every day, I wake up and face myself in the mirror. September, I go to chase hurricanes. But this hurricane stands out especially because it was Hurricane Irma. Not only was this hurricane incredibly bad and terrible, but it was one of the worst hurricanes, and it was extremely hard to chase because it was one of those hurricanes. The ones with the Cape Verde hurricanes are one of the worst hurricanes. As you can see, we already started preparing on the day of September 6, 2017. That was the day when Irma was making landfall with 185 miles per hour winds in Cuba. Fun. I don't understand. Yeah.
You can come.
Hurricane Irma also had a twin brother, Hurricane Jose. It was also reached a major hurricane status, but when Irma made landfall in Florida, things were not looking too good. On September 8th, 2017, Hurricane Irma was considered one of the most deadliest hurricanes on record, causing about $75 billion in damages and could have been $300 billion if it hit Miami. Hurricane Irma was also followed by Hurricane Jose and Hurricane Katia as they hit on the same day. September 6, 2017. Hurricane Irma was smashing the Caribbean. I started preparing for Hurricane Irma on the 7th. I actually didn't know when it was going to hit because it was such a big hurricane. So the reason why I decided to prepare for it on the 7th is because we didn't know when it actually would come. So I stayed here for a little bit. I was ready to chase the storm. Hurricane Irma was getting closer to Florida. I didn't even know what to do at that point. I prepared and prepared. September 9, 2017. Hurricane Irma was already hitting Miami as a Category 4 hurricane, making landfall in the Bahamas as a category 4. The problem with Hurricane Irma is that it made landfall as a major hurricane. I expected it to make landfall as a Category 2 or 3 or 4, but it hit as a Category 4. I expected it to make landfall as a Category 1 because whenever a hurricane touches land, it dissipates. So Hurricane Irma was a survivor to the max. It made Category 5 landfall in Bahamas and was coming right for Florida as a Category 4 major. On September 10th, 2017, the day of landfall of Hurricane Irma, it already started to look like this and was dumping heavy rain on where I was staying. I was staying in Miami and we were getting some pretty heavy rain and some pretty gusty winds. Hurricane Irma is getting ready. Hurricane Irma is getting ready to make landfall. It's already raining. We're getting winds of 24 miles an hour on my radar, according to. We're getting ready for this. Hurricane Irma is coming on shore. Right now, it's 1 p.m. We're getting 40 miles an hour wind. Here we go. The trees and plants are already feeling some side effects. Okay, I think we should go inside as the winds are getting pretty gusty right now. Yeah, here's what we're dealing with. Yikes.
Yeah.
Hurricane Irma. Whoa, roof shingles are coming off. Oh my god. Calm down a little bit. Oh, I hear thunder. Oh my god. Okay, alright, I think we're ready for this. It's about to get crazy. Alright, this thing has calmed down right now. It's just rain and thunder, but it's going to get much worse from here. I think we calmed down because we're in the eye, and the eye is the worst part of every storm. So Hurricane Irma 2017. Okay, it's here. It's finally here. Oh wow, this is a really bad hurricane.